Now, the future of Rabbitohs captain Adam Reynolds beyond this season remains undecided, but things are moving, and Hoops, you actually filed a story on this earlier today.
Yeah, so Adam Reynolds has met with the incoming Cronulla Sharks coach Craig Fitzgibbon in the last 48 hours. Fitzy's outlined the blueprint to the little number seven about why the black, white and blue club want him to be their on-field general from next year onwards. The offer will officially be tabled in the coming days. It'll be a three-year deal, we believe, worth around the $800,000 a season mark. I think, given everything that we've heard from Adam Reynolds so far, we'll see him take the deal and he'll be at the Cronulla Sharks next season.
So I think not only does Fitzgibbon probably need the scalp, but so do the Sharks, right? Because they've backed Fitzgibbon over Morris on the proviso that he can land players like this.
And he's gone out and done that. First real key signing for the club. So I think it's a real positive for...
Hasn't happened.
Offer he hasn't officially penned a paper, but I believe it's imminent, Ben. It will happen.
And look, certainly from Reynolds' side, there's been talk that if there's a three-year deal tabled in Sydney, in the vicinity of what Hoops is talking financially, that's what he was prepared to take, because the only problem with the South offer was it was for 1 year.
So
He wanted more time, so I think it looks like, as Hoops said, looks like he's going to take the deal.
Probably no surprise, but speaking to South today, it's not going to change their tune on things. They're still saying that a one-year deal really is all that they can offer, but for the Sharks, it'd be a great pickup for them. We already know what he can do in a game management sense, and it probably also takes the pressure off a bit on Craig Fitzgibbon on who he has to have next to him, even though, you know, that's still undecided. It's not something you'd have to rush into making who's his six tomorrow.
Well, particularly given they lost two, Lara, they've lost Townsend, because he was the game manager there. So the two halves that are left there, who are Johnson and Moylan, they're not your typical game managers that Reynolds is, so that's a big plus.
He's a cornerstone signing for the Sharks and for a new coach. Mm. Absolutely. He's one of those rare individuals, you know, which I used to love about Craig Bellamy with Cameron Smith and or Cooper Cronk. Trent Robinson had the same experience by the time Cronk arrived up there. Just sort of feed the game plan in and go out and knows how to execute it and under pressure in big games. That's the key. Now, you mentioned it, that the next step for Fitzgibbon is going to be deciding who plays alongside him in the halves. Sean Johnson was one of those options, and you've got a bit of breaking news on Johnson.
Oh, yeah, well, it's just a little background news, I suppose, Ben. What's happened there is Johnson, through his management, has offered himself back to the Warriors because, as we know, the Sharks have already come out and said, even though Johnson's looking for a two-year, $1.6 million deal, the Sharks have said, look, we'll give you 1 year at about $400,000, which is half. So his manager's gone back to the Warriors and said, are you guys interested? I understand the club there went to the senior players at the Warriors and said, are you guys keen to get him back? And they said, no, thanks, but no thanks was the way it was put to me. So that's an option off the table. So now it's going to be interesting to see how that plays out, because Sean Johnson is going to market. And we obviously know that Brisbane are a big believer in him and they're keen to get him. So looking more and more like, unless things change pretty rapidly at Cronulla, he might be heading north.
He's only just one or half a game or three quarters of a game back from a serious injury. So you'd imagine he'd want to be putting himself in the shop front window over the coming weeks, playing well. And if he's demanding big money, then he's got to show what he's.
I reckon this is a big decision for him. Like it's we mentioned this in the theme of Mitch Moses' future going to Brisbane, is that if Sean Johnson cops the big money to go to Brisbane and be the primary playmaker, as opposed to sitting outside Adam Reynolds, maybe getting three quarters or half of what he could get up there, you know, all the stuff that comes with the $1 million in Brisbane can eat at your soul.
Well, he's been there before, though, because we saw him have that pressure on his shoulders when he was at the New Zealand Warriors. And to your point earlier about when the Warriors canvassed his return with the senior players, I'm not surprised it didn't go down overly well, because if you remember when he left New Zealand, he had a fair bit to say on his way out the door about the club and about the forward pack, etc. So you're right, Ben. It's a big call. I just can't see how the Broncos are going to be left with too many other options. Adam Reynolds goes to Cronulla. Mitch Moses, as the days go by, he's going to stay at Parramatta.
Yeah, tell me more about why you think that. You've been strong on this. Why are you convinced Mitch stays with the Eels?
They're a top four club. They've got a recruitment and retention meeting on Friday, which crucially involves a lot of people, key stakeholders at the club, Brad Arthur, the chairman, Sean McElduff, the CEO, Jim Sarantinos. They've told Mitchell, we want you to be the halfback who takes us back to the promised land. They're in the midst of the longest premiership drought in NRL, of any NRL club at the moment, and certainly in the history of the Eels. He's the man. They've gone all in on him. They've presented the blueprint to him. And I believe that he's in turn told the club that he doesn't want to go anywhere. So yeah. All they've got to
and
do
it's
is sort out
competitive money that they've offered.
It's great
him.
Money.
Yep. Yeah.
It's a great deal. Like he can, if he wants to go to Brisbane for over $1 million a season, which would only be by the time you take the tax out, he's only going to be making maybe an extra $100,000 a year up there. Is it really worth?
Is the headache?
Is it worth
is the
all
headache,
the? Is the it worth all the torture?
I also think though, Sean Johnson's in a different place than Mitchell Moses, and I think he'd be more prepared to go to Brisbane at his stage of his career, given the significant. And I what I'm saying is, I think you get the players at a certain age where it becomes as much about the money, if not more about the money that you're being offered than anything else.
Maybe more prepared, but dare I say, less capable.
Yeah, I actually think Adam Reynolds is probably the only one out of those three that could handle the pressure.
I think you're right.
The money that comes, the pressure that comes with the money, the pressure that comes with trying to fix the Broncos. I don't think Sean Johnson would be able to fix it on his own, and yep. I don't think Mitch Moses, Reynolds, where he's at, could either.
Reynolds is one of those guys that can improve everybody around him. Just through his kicking game and his, which
his demeanor,
kick out his game,
his calm,
and, but
yeah.
Just all those little things just get everybody and makes everybody else do their job better. Whereas a player like Johnson, basically he is the game, and if his game is not on that day, then that's the end of Sean Johnson for really that game. His kicking game rarely gets the Sharks out of trouble, rarely got the Warriors out of trouble. Yeah, that's. I think
he's
Reynolds is the right fit.
Yeah, so yep. If I'm the Broncos, I'm going for Reynolds still. I know that the Sharks are offering huge money, great deal, 3 years. But if the Broncos really want to get themselves out of this mess, why wouldn't they come in and match it and make it
I think
it more?
He does want to go to Brisbane.
I know, but
Lara.
For what money? I mean,
you're saying everyone's got a price.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Let's just say Reynolds is on his way to Cronulla. Mitch Moses is going to stay with Parramatta. Tony Staggs, like there's this murmur around in the background. I keep hearing north of the border when I'm at home that the Broncos are confident. Mm. But then I get down here and there's this sense that perhaps Staggs could end up at Parramatta.
Why hasn't he signed?
I don't know.
If he wants to stay at the Brisbane Broncos, 4-year deal, $700,000 a season off an ACL reconstruction surgery, why would he have not put pen to paper if that's what he wants to do?
Am I right in saying
the Gold Coast have pulled their offer? Mm. They pulled their offer last week. So he's got the Brisbane Broncos. That offer's been sitting there for a number of months now. I just can't see why, if he's not going to put... Why hasn't he done it yet?
I don't want to start a conspiracy theory, but I quite enjoy doing it.
But I'm about to.
They have the same management company, Mitch Moses and Ketone Staggs. Is that right?
Yes, correct.
Right.
He'd be a great fit at the Parramatta.
The real
fascinating... Is that what you're saying?
But no comment. You're just going to throw that out there and let everyone just figure out.
Just ask the question. You know, if I had a halfback that wanted to win a comp at his current club and was getting good money, he wants good players around him, and he's already got a lot of those at Parramatta, but it wouldn't hurt having a gun outside back.
Mm. He'd bring a lot
17?
Of X factor to Parra. Like Parra, we talk about
that's
how
the
they haven't,
spot they really
they
need
haven't
help.
Taken their game to grand final winning proportions yet. So a player like Ketone could certainly do that.
To your point, Ben, the really fascinating 6 degrees of separation element of all of this seems how I know you want us to play all these cards. So Isaac Moses is currently deregistered and banned from dealing with NRL clubs. He's Mitchell Moses' cousin. He normally looks after him. Because Isaac's banned, that means that Stephen Moses, who's actually Mitchell's brother, is the agent currently negotiating with the Eels and any other club that wants to deal with Mitchell. Isaac also looks after Ketone Staggs, but he's banned at the moment, so he can't deal with clubs. So that means Stephen is currently dealing with any club that wants to handle Ketone Staggs negotiations.
What's your conspiracy theory make of that?
Are there a package deal?
Yeah. No, I'm just thinking that the longer it drags on in Brisbane and the fact that Moses has been offered to the Broncos, that perhaps there's always been this intent to have a halfback and a centre under the same manager arrive at the same club that's not Brisbane next year.
Here you go, Ben. I'll add a couple of more layers of complexity for you. Anthony Seibold, is managed by Isaac Moses. Obviously, he's now banned, but Isaac did the deal for him to go to Brisbane. That went pear-shaped. Isaac used to look after Kevin Walters, but when he and Anthony both went for the job at Brisbane and Seibold got it, Kevy then switched agents, got rid of Isaac. I know it's all very complicated and convoluted, but that's as inside and close to the bone as it gets.